To be with you this morning on Inauguration Day, in just a few hours, Joe Biden will be sworn in as president, and a new era will begin in the United States of America. What an exciting time to be alive. We are so happy that you are joining us today for our community gathering. Ooh, you know what? I'm going to pull up some riddles while we... Guys, let's do it all. While we go through our announcements, the yearbook photo submission deadline was extended. So they're due this Friday. You have to go online to take your photo for the yearbook. Reach out to Ms. Stern with any questions. Make sure you get your yearbook photos in. Dine and donate on Monday, January 25th at Mother Clucker's at 5200 North Elston Road. You have to mention CICS for 20% of sales to be donated. Wow. So head on out to Mother Clucker's. I'm assuming that that's a steak place. Mention CICS so that we get those proceeds or those sales. 20% of sales. That's better than proceeds, guys. Let's see. I've got some fun riddles. Here we go. Ooh. Okay. These are going to be hard, guys. This is... Okay. I mean, I don't know where these are coming from. So, all right, let's get into the Pride Points competition first while I pick one out. In fifth place, Miss Martirano. In fourth place, Mr. Fellows. In third place, Miss Houlihan. In second place, Miss Dunlap. And then finally, in first place, how is this possible? For some reason, Miss Dunlap is in second place and in the top spot. And I'm getting G-chats left and right, not probably. Oh, Miss Sparrow has a riddle. That's fantastic. Okay, congratulations to Miss Dunlap's class. It's a clean sweep for you guys. There we go. Let's put on some, there are some tunes for you. Here we go. Okay. Miss Sparrow's riddle will be our first riddle out of the gate. Here we go. I am a food and seed with three letters to my name. Take away two letters and I still sound the same. What am I? I'm a food and a seed with three letters to my name. Take away two letters and I still sound the same. Whew. Figure it out. All right, let's get into it. Everybody's favorite part of the community gathering, Pumas of the Week. All right, first out of the gate, as always, Miss Houlihan's class. We are so excited to celebrate this Puma as our Puma of the Week. His friends say, quote, he's always on top of things. He's in school every day and ready to learn. And he is a hardworking, awesome person. Thank you so much for all of your hard work and participation this year. You rock. Here he is, this week's Puma of the Week, coming out of Miss Houlihan's fifth grade class. Gabriel M. Woo! Okay, I'm gonna get out of this weird Beatles album. All right, here we go. On to our next one from Miss Dunlap's class. Congratulations to this Puma. We are so lucky to have you in our class. Daily, we see your kindness and leadership displayed. Your classmates that nominated you said, quote, because she's amazing, she's kind, happy, smart, and funny. She's always willing to help Reeb when Miss Dunlap doesn't want to anymore. When would that be, Miss Dunlap? Thank you for helping out in so many ways. Coming out of Miss Dunlap's fifth grade community, the Puma of the Week is Natalia W. Woo! Here we go. Let's see. Lots of feedback on the riddles and the and group chats. Here we go. I'm a food with I'm a food and seed with three letters to my name. Take away two letters and I still sound the same. What am I? Here we go. Let's figure it out. Pulling up the chat. Let's see. Joshua from Ms. Dunlap says, from Ms. Dunlap's class says T, but is T a seed? Not sure. Eileen from Ms. Franchik's class, Noah from Ms. Mandel's class, Maya from Ms. Martirano's class, all have the correct answer. Lyndon says pie, pie. Wonder you could have seeds inside of a pie possibly. But the given answer is P, like peas porridge hot, peas porridge cold, peas porridge in a pot 3 days old. All right, Cameron, also from Miss Houlihan's class, said P. Fantastic, great work. Okay, let's see. On to the next riddle. Here we go. Let's see. Sorry, everyone, 1 second. Okay. Here's a classic one. A boy and an engineer were fishing. The boy is the son of an engineer, but the engineer is the father of the boy. Then the boy is the son of the engineer, but the engineer is the father of the boy. Then who is the engineer? A boy and an engineer were fishing. The boy is the son of the engineer, but the engineer is the father of the boy. Oh, I think it's supposed to be the engineer is not the father of the boy. Then who is the engineer? Little typo there. The boy is the son of the engineer, but the engineer is not the father of the boy. Who is the engineer? Think on that as we move on to our sixth grade Pumas of the Week. Hold on, I've got a special request. This is not right. Hold on, I'll find it. Okay, coming out of Miss Mandel and Miss Mr. Orphan's class, we are truly honored to give this sixth grader Puma of the Week. He comes to school every day, ready to work with his camera on. He participates in class discussions while staying on top of his work in Summit. His classmates consider him to be both kind and funny. We are lucky to have both him and his Yoda doll in our sixth grade community. Coming out of Miss Mandel and Mr. Orphan's sixth grade community, the Puma of the Week is Andre V. Woohoo! Oh my goodness. Hold on. I wanna believe that you don't have a bad body. Woo! Way to go, Andre! But the bruises on your ego make you go wild. Wanna believe that even when you're stone cold, you're sorry. Right. Tell me why you gotta be so. Okay, here we go. Coming out of Miss Franchik's class. This Puma is described by her classmates as kind, friendly, and understanding. This Puma has a strong work ethic and she's always ready to help other Pumas if they struggle. This Puma has big dreams for the future. She's an activist who wants to make the world a better place. One day, this Puma will become a well-known rocket scientist. We are so proud of you and cannot imagine our classroom community without you. Here she is, this week's Whom of the week from Miss Franchick's sixth grade community, the one, the only, Zamira. Oh! When it come on, everybody looking for a dance to run on. If you want to run away with me, I know a galaxy and I can take you for a ride. Way to go! Imagine that we fell into a rhythm where the music don't stop for life. Glitter in the sky, glitter in my eyes, shining just the way you like. Woo-hoo. If you feel like you need a little bit of company, you met me. Okay, here we go. The boy and an engineer were fishing. The boy is the son of the engineer, but the engineer is not the father of the boy. Then who is the engineer? All right, let's figure it out. Confusing because of the way that it was written. Let's see. wow. Okay. So the boy is the son of the engineer. So things like uncle, grandpa, not exactly right. Somebody said that the engineer isn't related, but a few people are right on. Jameson, Mr. Sloan, Michelle from Miss Vanderbosch's class, an anonymous Puma from Miss Diaz's class, all said that the engineer is the mom. It's the mom. So yeah, uh-huh. That's a classic riddle. There's a whole Cosby Show episode about it. We probably shouldn't talk about the Cosby Show, but anyway, that's where I remember it from. But yeah, the engineer is the mom. Ladies can be engineers. I know a few lady engineers. Okay, female engineers. Here we go, on to our next Puma of the week. This Puma has been really stepping up to the plate in this virtual learning setting. She's been working super hard and it shows. She also knows how to make people smile and loves to help others in small group. This Puma really is sick, not basic. Coming out of our seventh grade community, the Puma of the week is Monica C. Way to go, Monica. Shoes on, get up in the morning, cup of milk, let's rock and roll. Kink out, get the drum running on like a Rolling Stone. Sing song when I'm walking home, jump up to the top of the brown. Ding dong, come here, go. Nice tea, and I'll get my ping pong. This ain't heavy, ain't hit a bass, boom, I'm ready. Your life is sweet as honey, get this beach chain like money. Here we go, coming out of Mr. Fellow's class. Sorry, I was pulling up a request. Direct quote from a classmate. This Puma was nominated, quote, because she is an amazing friend and she's very smart and she is great and helpful and caring. Coming out of Mr. Fellow's seventh grade class, the Puma of the week is Catherine M. Woo-hoo! Tell you what, if the requests are going to be like this, keep them coming. All right, here we go. Let's get another riddle going before we get into our next one. Let's see. What lives in winter, dies in summer, and grows with its roots upward? What lives in winter, dies in summer, and grows with its roots upward? All right. On to Miss Diaz and Miss Sparrow's Puma of the Week. Here we go. Zoom. She's got it. Assessments. Bring it on. Being a good friend? Easy. We're not sure how you do it all, but we are sure that we are lucky to have you in our class. Keep up the great work and communication. We know you are going to knock eighth grade out of the park. Here they are from Miss Diaz and Miss Sparrow's eighth grade community, the Puma of the week is Jaceli B. On to the next one from Miss Martirano's class. Coming out of the graduating class, this Puma shows pride every day. She always finds a way to participate, even when her mic doesn't work. Her peers say she is a great friend and fun to talk to. She's also very helpful in class, and she's a fun person overall. That's a direct quote. Thanks for being you and showing us what it means to be an eighth grade leader. Coming out of Miss Martirano's class and our eighth grade community, the Puma of the week is Yossi Chief. Let's get our answer to our riddle. What lives in the winter, dies in the summer, and grows with its roots upward? Its roots going up. Miss Vanderbosch says a mole rat. Not sure about that one. let's see. Charisma has the right answer. Tayden, or the given answer, I'll say. Tayden. Lyndon is close, but the given answer is icicle. An icicle lives in the winter, dies in the summer. Although it's rare that an icicle makes it all the way to summer, I will say. All right, let's do our staff of the week. This Puma staff member is an amazing math teacher. She has such a calming presence, a contagious smile, and brings math to life with her real-world examples and activities. She goes above and beyond each and every day to meet the needs of all of our students, of her students. We are so glad she joined our IP community this year. Thank you for all of your hard work. Here she is, this week's Staff of the Week, coming out of sixth grade, the one, the only, Miss Franchek! Working so hard. All right. All right, that's going to do it for us today. Thank you, thank you, thank you for your attendance, your engagement, your enthusiasm, all of the above, your riddle answers. Work hard, do your best. And as always, if you're proud to be a Puma, let me hear you say Puma Pride. Have a great day, everybody.